in the field of early childhood development. So I hope you guys will enjoy this session. Still, this area is still unexplored in ACF, and I hope you will enjoy the session today. So here we go. Thank you, Shivangi, and a very good afternoon to everyone. Shivangi has already introduced me, but I would just like to talk about the topic that I would be, you know, talking about. And we've specifically taken ECD or early childhood development. And today I would, if you're wondering, you know, ACF is basically a health and nutrition based organization. So why do we need to know about early childhood education or early childhood development as such? So I will just try to cover these aspects and talk about, present my ideas of what exactly is early childhood development. Is it same as early childhood education? Can we use them interchangeably, ECE and ECD? Also, again, the main aspect of, if we understand what is ECD, then what are the things and why do we need to integrate early stimulation with nutrition programs? So, as we all know, the UNTRC as well as the Constitution of India, we define a child as a human being who is below the age of 18. And both these, the UNCRC as well as the Constitution of India, also guarantees certain rights for our children, you know, children who are below 18 years. And these rights include the right to live, right to grow properly. Children have the right to be provided basic health services. They need to be provided good nutrition, good care. Again, no discrimination, whether it's a girl or a boy, whether from a rich or a poor background, from disadvantaged communities, or on the basis of religion, language, or caste. So these rights, basic rights, are guaranteed to the children. And with this basic understanding that our children enjoy these basic rights, we need to understand why are we specifically talking about early childhood and who exactly are these children that we are talking about in early childhood. Now, in the Indian context, generally early childhood is considered as, you know, the preschool years or the years before which a child attends a formal school. And since a child starts attending a formal school at the age of around 6 years, early childhood is considered as below 6 years. Also, this is reflected in our the major program that we have, integrated child development services. If you see, the services provided by this program also talks about children below 6 years. So in the Indian context, an understanding is that when we talk about early childhood, we are talking about children from 0 to 6, from birth to 6 years. But internationally, I would like to point out that early childhood years are years from birth to 8 years. So the first few years of the early grades are also included in as part of early childhood years. And the different stages, we understand, you must be aware of the different stages in this early childhood years. It includes the period before birth or the prenatal period, because we understand that this is the period which has a major impact on the child's later life. Whatever the mother eats, often, you know, the mothers are told by the older ladies in the family, listen to good and soothing music, listen to religious texts, you know, be happy, because we have that understanding, and it is scientifically proven also that the prenatal period has an impact on the child's later life. As soon as the child is born, we say till the child is around 2 years, the child is referred to as an infant. And this is the period when the child learns to crawl, slowly learns to walk, is starts exploring the world with his or her senses. The child starts forming attachment with the primary caregivers, with the family members. So this is the time from birth to 2 years that we refer to as the infancy. Preschool years, as you understand, is the time when the child starts interacting with people outside the family. So the child starts interacting with more friends. In fact, his or her physical capabilities also start improving. Motor abilities become better. They make new friends. And they start moving a little outside of the house. And then comes the early middle childhood years, which are included in the as part of the early childhood years, from 6 to around 8 years, when the child starts a formal school. He or she starts making more friends, becomes more social, the capabilities, physical capabilities, the cognitive capabilities are further enhanced. So this is the time frame that internationally is recognized as the period of early childhood, from birth to prenatal period till around 8 years of a child's life. But why are we talking about these early childhood years? Why are these early childhood years important? It is often said that working with children and their families in the early years is like investing in the future. And this is so because the early years have been scientifically proven to be the critical period for a child's development. They are the window of opportunity. The experiences, if the child has positive experiences in this period, from birth to 8 years, they have a positive impact on the overall development of the child. Whereas any negative experience that the child has during this period leaves an irreversible negative impact on the child. And what exactly is this impact that we are talking about? Well, 0 to 8 being the foundation years, it has an impact on the overall development of the child. So the cognitive skills, the child's thinking ability, the child's ability to reason, the child's memory is getting enhanced, child is able to solve, has more problem-solving capabilities. At the same time, the ability to express oneself through language also improves, and the child learns language, learns to express himself or herself. This is also the time when the child learns to relate to others. So if positive experiences the child has during this time will have an effect on how as an adult this particular child relates to others in his or her life. So whether the child is a social person, how friendly is he, what are at the workplace, what are his dynamics with the others. Also, it has an impact on the emotional development of the child. So if the child is praised during the early years, he or she gains a lot of confidence, self-confidence, the self-esteem grows. He or she learns to manage his emotions and the importance of EQ we understand in these days. So all the foundation for all this is laid in the early years. The next point that is elaborated on the slide is very familiar to you, I believe, and it has experiences in the early years have a positive impact on health and nutrition, on survival rates, on the chances of catching infections. Very good habits related to sanitation and hygiene, like washing your hands. The foundation is laid in this in the early years of the child's life. Now, this is not the only impact that the experiences, positive experiences, have on child's on children. Children who attend a good quality early childhood program, research has shown that the children tend to have to perform better in primary school. So the retention rates are better. Dropout rates are reduced. There are less chances of, you know, repeating a certain grade, and the general scholastic or the achievement or the performance in school is generally enhanced if a child has been exposed to a high quality early childhood program. It would be then fair to say that all these, you know, they have a combining effect, and early childhood development and programs related to it also have a positive impact on the families and communities, because there is a general improvement in the understanding on health and hygiene. You know, families, mothers, caregivers understand what food is nutritious for my child, what food is good for me. They also have an impact on the education of the child. You know, educating the girl child is important. And in many situations, it has been found that a good early childhood program tends to a community where there are good early childhood programs, the child marriages have come down. Families have become smaller. It also has an impact on the gap between between two children. In turn, it also has an impact on the women participation in economic activities. It has an impact on the making the population more healthy, a better labor force, less crime. So it would be safe to say that the early childhood programs not only have an impact on the child, but they also have impact on their families, on the communities, and on the nation as a whole. This is one way of looking at it. And another very strong evidence which has come from the field of neurosciences is related to brain development. Now, it is said that the brain size doubles in the first year of the child's birth. And by the age of 3 years, the child's brain is 80% formed. And the brain basically, we have a basic understanding of how brain works. And brain works through these neurons. The neurons are like wires in the brain, and they are connected to one another with synaptic connections. And it is believed that the more number of synaptic connections we have, it is the better ability the brain has to function. And at birth, we have billions of neurons. A child is born with billions of neurons. And if the synaptic connections don't happen, then these neurons slowly tend to die. They tend to wither away. And we are left, a child might be left with less number of neurons. And how do these synaptic connections happen? They happen because of stimulation. They happen because of stimulation. They happen because of good nutrition. They happen because of reduced illnesses. When a child is provided good nutrition, up to 75% of each meal goes to build this child's brain. When the child is protected and is immunized, has access to safe drinking water, the chances of illnesses and disease is reduced. That is the time when a child's brain development is promoted. A child's brain is, these synaptic connections, like I said, they happen when the child is provided early stimulation. Now, the meaning of early stimulation is very simple. Listening to different sounds, when the child is talked to, when the child is smiled at, when the child, you know, is able to make eye contact with the primary caregivers and the family members, very small babies, when they look at faces, when we know that the child cannot talk, when the, you know, in just after birth or in the early years of infancy, but the child is listening to you. So when the people are, the family members are talking to the child, narrating stories, looking at pictures, the child looks at shapes, on at patterns, maybe picture books, they form a very good way of, you know, stimulating these synaptic connections in the brain of the child. Physical contact is a very important aspect of, you know, of make of these synaptic connections, of providing the early stimulation. So when the child is hugged, when the child is, you know, cuddled, the child is, the massage that we give to a newborn baby, that is very important. It is also that physical touch is again helping in those, making those synaptic connections and strengthening the brain, as we say. You know, often we would have these in extended families. We have, you know, the grandmothers, nani, dadi, telling stories to children, singing lullabies and songs. All this is contributing to the brain development of the child. Going to the park, explaining things, showing them, you know, squirrels and rats and cats. So all that is, in a way, helping the child's brain development. Another very important aspect is when we, the research has shown that when there is stress in terms of abuse, violence or neglect, that is the time when the synaptic connections do not tend to be formed, and that is detrimental for the brain development. Now, when all these things, like I said, are happening, the early stimulation part, when the child is talked to, smiled at, hugged, cuddled, taken care of, and the child is made to feel loved, the child's brain development is normal. And if all this is missing and there is stress or abuse or violence in the family, or in the child is experiences violence or abuse, that is a form of neglect. And as you can see on the slide, it has a very detrimental effect on the child's brain development. So we can say that although the child is, you know, these children are surviving, they are not thriving. There is, this also leads to a loss of human potential, because these, the children who are neglected are not able to reach their developmental potential, and therefore it leads to a loss of human potential as well. So this is what is basically ECD, the components of ECD. But often, you know, ECD and ECE are used interchangeably. Here I would like to say that ECE is a part of ECD. ECD is more holistic. It is more, it covers all domains of development. And as we mentioned, ECD covers the age group from birth to 8 years. And it covers the important components of nutrition, health, education and protection, involving the safety and security of our children. So therefore, on the other hand, ECE is more related to the preschool education component of the program, wherein we are talking about emergent literacy, we are talking about school readiness, we are talking about number concepts, and it is more center-based rather than home-based stimulation, whereas ECD is more home-based, although you know, programs have incorporated them as center-based programs also. So ECE is a sub-component or a sub-part of ECD, whereas ECD is the larger domain or the picture that we have. Like I said, ECD includes various other aspects of education, health, nutrition, protection, and this is an important part of the SDGs or the Sustainable Development Goals. As indicated, ECD is a part of the transformative agenda or the goals for 2030. ECD is also reflected in another very important document which has been released by WHO, which is called the Nurturing Care Framework. This document also, if you see, the components are responsive caregiving, adequate nutrition, good health, safety and security. So again, all the components are included in the concept of ECD. They are mutually supportive. They interact in mutually supportive ways. And there is an integration of these programs across the sectors that we talk about. Now, this has been also reiterated. The importance of ECD has been reiterated by World Bank, wherein it has been found that if early stimulation, ECD, is included in the programs, it has a long-term impact on stunting and nutrition, other nutrition interventions. So, we have kind of established what that ECD is an important aspect and needs to be integrated with the nutritional programs. But the important question is, how do we do it? How do we integrate these? It is easier said than done, and especially in the field. Well, I would like to give a few examples of the ECD, of the programs which have integrated ECD and nutrition interventions. And the basic components included are talking to parents about early stimulation while we are talking to them about nutritional aspects. So if, for example, if we are talking, we are emphasizing on exclusive breastfeeding and the importance of breastfeeding for children below 6 months of age, we are also talking about, you know, it is important that the mother maintains eye contact while breastfeeding the child. Mother, you know, is talking to the child, singing him a lullaby while breastfeeding. Not only while breastfeeding, but when the child grows up and it's time to start complementary feeding. Again, you know, basically parents are talking to the child. They are maintaining eye contact. When we are working in the kitchen or we are doing our daily chores, the mothers, they can still be talking to the children. They can be talking to them about, you know, what happened during the day. She can be, if the child is old enough, she can ask the child, how was the day? How were your friends? What games did you play with your friends? What are your feelings right now? So basically a lot of interaction, parent-child interaction is encouraged and emphasized when we are talking about these nutritional interventions. Another thing which has worked in many programs is continued and regular home visits. So the home visits basically provide a very good way of observing the behavior of the parents, as well as it helps in problem solving. You know, if there is a certain problem encountered by a parent and the people are visiting, they can help in solving those problems and observing the correct and the appropriate behavior with the children. So home visits are again a very good way of integrating ECD and nutrition programs. Another very important part of this integration is creating care groups or support groups, wherein parent and children attend these programs at the center together. So this forms a very a good platform where discussions are held on child care practices. You know, mothers discuss what works for them, they exchange notes, They narrate their experiences, and these can generally be held on community health days, like the village health and nutrition day that we have in our various states. Again, a participatory approach is very important, wherein the feedback from the mothers, the caregivers, is often incorporated into the program that we are talking about. And another very important aspect of integrating, how to integrate the ECD and nutrition intervention is through structured curriculum or training modules. I would explain about these a little more, but I would also first like to give examples of programs where ECD and nutrition interventions have been integrated. They have been integrated in countries like Bangladesh, Pakistan, Jamaica, Kenya, and many other African countries. Now, these are good examples, especially the Bangladesh example I would like to elaborate on. If you see on the slide also, it talks about, you know, basically Bangladesh is a poor country with a very high population density. However, the government recognizes the benefits of ECD, and they have incorporated its ECD into its national plan of action. And how this ECD has been integrated is through two ways, the existing nutrition and health programs, as well as utilizing the existing infrastructure for promoting ECD. So around 12,000 community clinics are promoting ECD and the message of ECD, wherein the staff has been trained in ECD, on components related to stimulation, play for children, health, nutrition, education, protection and safety and security of the children. All this, the staff has been trained, and through an integrated community development program, the message of ECD is being communicated. Another thing which Bangladesh is doing is having parenting education program. So again, parents are educated on the importance of nutrition for children, on play stimulation, and the importance of play, parent and child interaction. So again, emphasizing the importance of interaction, talking to the child, playing with the child, providing them material, making eye contact, singing to the child, showing them storybooks, all that is part of the parental education program. And of course, they also have, Bangladesh also has a separate preschool program which caters to the school readiness aspect and talks about language skills, numeracy and number concepts and all that. So this is a good model which I wanted to share, where ECD and nutritional interventions have been integrated. Another example is of a structured curriculum which talks about psychosocial stimulation for young children is the Care for Child Development. Now, this Care for Child Development, or CCD, is basically a joint program by UNICEF and WHO, which talks about enhancing the caregiver's sensitivity. You know, a caregiver sensitivity of observing the child's behavior. So the program talks about something called serve and return. You know, as in certain sports, you have the child serves at you and then you return accordingly. The parent has to return accordingly. For example, you know, a 6-month-old or a 7-month-old is pointing towards a ball that is placed in the room, or pointing towards a bottle that is placed in the room. So that observing that behavior and then responding to it. Oh, you want to play with the ball? Oh, you want to play with the bottle? You want the bottle? You want water? And responding accordingly. The caregiver has to respond accordingly. So serve and return, kind of a scenario wherein it encourages play and communication between caregiver and the child. It is explained with a toolkit which has a lot of pictures. If I could show you an example of the card that the Care for Child Development program has, and if you see, it again talks about you know, talking to the child, making eye contact, giving child simple play material, you know, rattles, or making some low cost material for the child, and encouraging a lot of interaction between children and their primary caregivers. So these are the, it also has kind of a checklist wherein the program staff then goes and checks if the mother is, you know, during the home visits, if the mother or the caregiver is following appropriate practices, child care practices, and what needs to be done more if, for example, it is the mother is unable to follow these appropriate practices. What are the ways in which the mother can be helped in understanding what is good for the child? So these are the basic aspects which I wanted to highlight, how ECD has been integrated with nutritional interventions. And now I would request, if you have any questions, any feedback that you want to share with me, I would request you to share and open the forum. So, okay, Pavan has asked if are there any interventions targeted towards child's neurodevelopment delivered during the pregnancy? I'll have to go back and look at it, but as far as I know, the interventions are not related, targeted towards only neurodevelopment. You know, they are targeted at providing the basic components which help in the development of the overall development of the baby. So again, emphasizing on the nutrition, on protecting the mother from various illnesses. Those are the aspects that we are talking about. But specifically towards neurodevelopment, I don't think that's specific. I'm not aware. Maybe if I find, I will like to share this. Okay, so Meeta says, could you please briefly share what tools can be used for monitoring and measuring the impact of intervention? Okay, so as far as the ECD intervention is concerned, you know, like I said, the UNICEF and WHO has this structured curriculum, and it's called the Care for Child Development, and they have this checklist, the last slide that I showed, wherein during the home visits, the mother's appropriate childcare practices, they can be kind of observed, and accordingly feedback can be provided to the mother. This is related to very small children, but there are other tools also available, standardized tools. For example, UNICEF is in the process of almost finalizing a tool called ELDS, Early Learning Development Scale. Now, ELDS, I would repeat, ELDS. Now, this is not yet in the public domain because they are finalizing, but it is been it is quite a good it is a very good tool which looks at development and learning from a holistic point of view. And this is a tool basically for below 5 years. Right now it is available for children from 3 to 6 years, from 0 to 3, ages and stages is again a very good tool which talks about how to you know, how the development of the based on the milestones of the milestones of development, how the child is progressing on these milestones. So ages and stages for 0 to 3, for 3 to 6, ELDS. There is another tool which is by the World Bank, which is more related to school readiness. So that is called the SRI. SRI, it is School Readiness Index, which looks at how well the child, how ready is the child for school. So again, basic, this is a standardized tool available with World Bank. Again, this can be used. In addition, these are standardized tools, but in addition, we have various other checklists and you know, which are based on the developmental milestones of the children to understand how well they are progressing related to the learning and development. And health and nutrition, I'm sure you are familiar with, you know, the basic indicators that we use. Okay, so are there, Kuldeep Singh says, are there any major developmental milestones that can be focused to be implemented under program at community level? Yes, like I said, there are these developmental milestones, and for each group there are different, like I said, ages and stages gives you a good. So for very small and babies, you know, we talk about how well are they holding their head, are they able to roll over, are they able to crawl, are they able to sit from a sleeping position, are they able to sit, what is the age when they start taking their first step, when they start walking. So these are the milestones that I'm talking about, and these have been documented in the ages and stages, as well as other various checklists that are available for seeing the you know, the milestones of children. So Pavan says, what different games that are being used for ECD in various programs? Is there any repository that you can refer us? We are in design phase of our revised 100 days program. Okay, so yes, there are developmental kits that are available, ECD kits. Again, UNICEF has an ECD kit. Even Ministry of Women, Department of Women and Child Development, Delhi government has an ECE kit. There are, which basically, you know, it consists of, and this kit, you know, if you look at the kit, it is a compilation of very simple things like a medium-sized ball, a few rattles, ice cream sticks. There are, you know, these foam shapes, puzzles, blocks. So these are the various, you know, things, simple things that we can, even low cost material can be developed, you know, simple scribbling, writing material, playing in the sand. So these are the various things that are encouraged, and these kits are available, but it is not that we need to go by the available kits. We can definitely create our own also by incorporating these basic ingredients. Okay, Rajesh asks, what are the key activity interventions we can promote which are found very significant as ECD? So like I've been in my presentation also, I've been trying to highlight the importance of caregiver and child interaction. So it is very important that whatever the work the mother is doing, you know, at the while doing those chores, you know, if she's talking to the child, if she's maintaining eye contact, if she's asking how the child is feeling, what did the child do throughout the day, the father comes home maybe in the evening and, you know, just spends half an hour, 40 minutes talking to the child. These are important. If there is a, if we are talking about younger kids from 0 to 3, while feeding the child, singing them lullabies, while you know, making them sleep, you know, you talk to them, tell them stories, narrate your experiences, describe things, events, taking them to the park, taking them to the market, and, you know, showing, exposing them to the. So these are the different ways which can promote, you know, a child's brain development, his overall development. So this needs to be communicated to the parents again and again, the importance of this. Often what happens is that, you know, mothers, you know, oh, I'm so busy, I don't have time for this. You know, he's playing, he's sitting alone, I have given him food, I fed him, he's not hungry anymore, so that should be sufficient. But that more needs to be done in terms of caregiver and child interaction, more eye contact, more hugging, more cuddling of the child, making the child sit in the lap. So these kind of behaviors need to be, and again, you know, if the child throws a temper tantrum, if the child has committed a mistake, how to, you know, handle that situation, not to get angry with the child, how to you know, logically and with reason explain why the child has done something wrong, and ask him not to repeat that wrong. So these are the things that we are talking about when we are talking about ECD intervention.
I was thinking there are a lot, many of questions are coming up, but it is all about thank you. So maybe still I'll wait for 2-3 minutes more if we have any questions. Otherwise, we would wrap up the session. Okay, so there's one more question.
Okay, so Aparna has asked if the Bailey scale index has been incorporated into the program for first 1,000 days in India. Is this something that can be used? Okay, so Bailey's scale definitely is a very good scale in terms of you know, monitoring children's growth and development. It is a standardized scale. It has used world over, and it has its reliability and validity established. That having said, at times when it is a good scale to use, but at times one feels that, you know, it is more health and nutrition oriented rather than stimulation oriented. One point. The other is also that it is also quite an intensive test. You know, it takes a lot of time for the Bailey scale to be administered, and there are certain preconditions generally in a center based situation it is used. So it is a good tool, it has been incorporated, that is fine, but I would say in a community or in a home based program, it might be a little, it might prove a little challenging to administer Bailey scale on children. Okay, so Pawan is asking what is the alternative in community level. I would say looking at ages and stages is a good idea. Looking at ELDS is a good idea. These are more user-friendly, more easily administered scales. Looking at CCD, the last two slides that I showed, they are again good tools. But I would at the moment there is a lot of utility of ELDS and ages and stages. So I would say these are more easily administered and can be used at the community level. Okay, so Aparna is asking, do you know of large-scale interventions in India or globally that have provided successful outcomes? So I'm assuming the large-scale interventions are wherein ECD and nutrition are integrated. Is that what you want? Because I know of various interventions which have been done separately, but I cannot right now think of any large-scale intervention which has been done as an integrated effort. You know, although we do say that ICDS is an integrated program, but again, as we all know, when it is administered, it is implemented, it is done in a very sectoral form, wherein the nutrition aspect is different, education aspect is different, and 0 to 3 early stimulation for 0 to 3 is entirely missing. So I wouldn't say large scale interventions at the moment are available as such in India. Okay, so Aparna is saying any known examples would be helpful as a reference point of integrating. So let me just do my homework and get back to you, Aparna. If I do come across, I will definitely send them to you, detailed reports. I would look at the programs that are available and see if I can find one. Pawan, yes? Yes, you may contact me when you're designing your 100 days intervention. I would love to be involved.
So I think we all are done with the questions. Okay, so maybe Aparna is coming up with another question. Okay, yes, please.
Enter. Okay, so maybe we wind up this session over here. So before we wrap up, do you have any last like concluding message for the team to take home message?
Okay, so I see a lot of, you know, you are in that planning stage where you are talking about planning interventions for the first 1,000 days. So I would just say, the program staff, the people that you're working with, they should be convinced that ECD is important, early stimulation is important, and this message will only get, you know, will get across if we are convinced that this is an important thing. So I would say that, you know, be convinced yourself first, and then have repeated small messages, direct messages for the mothers, and incorporate a lot of home visits wherein, you know, you can go and observe their child practices, and also create support groups wherein, you know, the mothers, it acts as a catharsis for the mothers. They come, they discuss, and they take back a lot, you know. So I would say incorporate these aspects, especially in the planning stage, and good luck.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Dr. Neelima, for your experience, your ideas and thoughts on early childhood development. And thank you everyone for participating in this session. So I don't know whether you will miss it or not, but I will really going to miss this learning week after today. It was really engaging and exciting event that was there for a week. I hope everyone enjoyed this session and even this entire learning week. Thanks for your support. Thank you so much. The video and the PowerPoint presentation I will share soon, and it will be available on the Knowledge Hub. So thank you so much again. Have a lovely weekend. Bye-bye.